Hi, in this video about Monad. Monad is a new EVM-compatible Layer 1 blockchain, and just like many other Layer 1s, it aims to be decentralized, secure, and with high throughput. Why do we need higher throughput and another Layer 1 again? Well, there are already many, that's evident. Existing Layer 1s cannot really cater the scalability requirements that we even need now and will need in the future, because if you think of that, the number of dApps and the amount of people that are using crypto is only going to increase. And for that, many are introducing layer 2s or some kind of other solutions to increase the throughput. But most people would rather have their block space and the throughput on the layer of layer 1. Yes, a tautology, but basically that's because rollups and any kind of layer 2 solutions may introduce centralization points. And of course, that's debatable, but that they may do so. And other solutions may not be as secure as decentralized or as compatible with other dApps. So, for example, not all rollups are compatible with every dApp on Ethereum. Monad, on the other hand, aims to achieve the throughput just on the level of rollups or even higher at 10,000 transactions per second. However, it aims to be purely on layer 1. The way Monad achieves this high throughput is by optimizing its software using asynchronous execution and parallelization of transactions. Let's start with the first one. Asynchronous execution allows you to execute transactions simultaneously without waiting for the older ones to be completed. So you divide the process of execution into two stages. First, consensus, and second, execution. This way, Monad aims to be optimizing each process separately, and then the blockchain would run faster. However, there is one question left. How do you decide the order of transactions? And for that, Monad would use heuristics, and that is just a word for math, certain math to decide on the order of transactions. The consensus stage is done between all nodes and uses a protocol called Tendermint. And the consensus mechanism itself is a proof of stake, just like Ethereum. Speaking of proof of stake, decentralization is often a sensitive topic when you mention that type of consensus, because for everybody, the level of decentralization that they would accept as good is varying, because we don't have like a definition that X number of nodes is decentralized or X number of whatever is decentralized. Monad has 150 nodes in consensus, and that number is yet to be finalized, that is just for the moment. However, let's get back to asynchronous execution. And another blockchain that you can technically compare Monad to a little bit is Solana, because it also has this type of asynchronous execution. However, Solana uses a different consensus, that is proof of history, and it is also not EVM compatible. And Monad aims to be like a better version of Solana, at least that's how I see it puts itself, to be honest. Apart from asynchronous execution, Monad also has parallelization of transactions, as I previously said. To be parallelized, and that is just to be processed simultaneously, transactions need to be independent. So Monad uses certain heuristics to determine whether transactions are at all connected to each other. If they are not connected and they are independent, they are processed simultaneously, and that tremendously increases the throughput, as you might guess. However, and again, the question of the ordering of transactions, and as I said, Monad uses heuristics to determine that. The Monad team is currently preparing for the testnet release in the quarter one of this year, so in 2023, it will release first the private testnet, and after extensive testing, as I like to say, they will have a public testnet. And then the mainnet is planned for summer this year as well. I also found some information on the node requirements that are likely to be during the testnet, so you can start preparing the servers or know if you would like to participate. They're not too high. So they are 8-core CPU with 3.2 frequency and 16 gigabytes of RAM and 2 terabytes of SSD storage. You also need quite a high internet speed. Speaking of the team behind Monad, it consists of 10 people. However, I suspect there are already more because it is hiring at the moment, and you can watch all the open job positions on AngelList. The founders are coming from developing high-frequency trading system in jump trading previously. Now for the social aspects and for funding of Monad. So who invested in Monad is not exactly clear. However, they had one early stage VC round, and the information in their Discord that I was able to find is that Dragonfly Capital, Placeholder Capital, Kobe, and Hasu invested into it. And I don't know how like true is that is, because that is not verified, as I said, and there is also no information on how much was invested. Despite its novelty, it has a very like large and popular Twitter, I would say, because Monad ranks quite high on Coins Guru, and that means that many notable followers follow the account, and including Dragonfly Capital, Paradigm, Jump Capital, and the founders of other things. You can just follow their Twitter for further announcements. However, if you would like to participate more actively in the community, you can also get to their Discord. However, the Discord is closed, and to get into it, you need an invite link from Bill. I will leave the link to Bill's Twitter. You should DM him and tell him why you would like to join Monad, and he will assist you further. And that's all I have for you about Monad as of now. Stay tuned for any kind of other news, because it's still early, as I said. And let me know if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.